Our warfare are not carnal, but mighty through God to the pulling down of strongholds. Every stronghold in your life will be pulled down. You will live to see the day of victory. Casting down imaginations and every high thing that exalteth itself against the knowledge of God, and bringing into captivity every thought to the obedience of Christ. That's why there's nothing to fear. The Lord will moderate, supervise everything that comes to you. Nothing beyond your strength will be allowed to come to you. That's why you are going to overcome. 1 Corinthians chapter 10. Verse 13. 1 Corinthians chapter 10, verse 13. There has no temptation taken you, but such as is common to man. That's what God will do. He will not allow anything beyond your strength to come unto you. If anything comes, look around the corner. There is strength, ability, courage, confidence. There's something God has given you there that will make you overcome. But God is faithful, who will not permit you, allow you, suffer you to be tempted above that ye are able, but will the temptation also make a way to escape, that ye may be able to bear it. You will bear it. But you need to put on the whole armor of God. We're looking at Ephesians chapter 6. Ephesians chapter 6 from verse 10. In Ephesians chapter 6 verse 10, finally, my brethren, be strong in the Lord and in the power of his might. He is available. His strength is available. His power is available for you. Put on the whole armor of God, that ye may be able to stand. Put it on, the whole armor of God, that you'll be able to stand against the wiles of the devil. For we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities and powers, against the rulers of the darkness of this world, against spiritual wickedness in high places. And all those people that Paul the Apostle referred to, striving, battling, in conflict, wrestling with powers of darkness, he overcame. Now they are in heaven waiting for us. And they are watching, that as they put on the whole armor and they overcame, if we put on the same armor, we are going to overcome. Wherefore take unto you the whole armor of God, that ye may be able to withstand in the evil day. Anybody can stand when there's no temptation, when everybody is friendly, when there's no problem, when there's no scarcity. Anybody can worship God. Anybody can read the Bible. Anybody can feel happy when there's enough money, enough food, when everybody is helping us, when everybody is respecting us. Anybody can serve God in easy situations. The challenge is when things turn around, when persecution comes, when there is a niche in our lives, and when friends turn to become foes, and when people that used to flatter us, when they now despise us and insult us. The challenge is that at that time, when the flatterers become the despisers, that we're still able to stand and worship God. That's the beauty. That's the glory. But you know, to say I'm serving God and there's no challenge, there's no problem, there's no persecution, that's easy. Anybody can do that even without grace. The evidence of the grace of God is that when the persecution is there, when the insult is there, when the challenges are there, that we're able to stand. Wherefore, take unto you the whole armor of God, that ye may be able to withstand in the evil day, and having done all to stand. Stand therefore, having your loins girt about with truth, having on the breastplate of righteousness, and your feet shod with the preparation of the gospel of peace, above all taking the shield of faith, wherewith ye shall be able to quench, how many fiery darts? All. Take that faith, take that faith. That shield of faith will quench all the fiery darts of the wicked. And take the helmet of salvation, and the sword of the Spirit, which is the word of God, praying always with all prayer and supplication in the Spirit, and watching thereunto with all perseverance and supplication for all saints. If we do that, we'll overcome. I'm sure you have even overcome already. You will go from strength to strength and from power to power. We will share testimonies of victory together in Jesus' name. Let me show you. I'm reading something to you now. This is your story. This is your story. You would like to see your story in the Bible. Job chapter 17 verse 9. Job chapter 17 verse 9. The righteous, are they there? The righteous shall hold on his way. That's your story. Don't change the story. You will hold on. And you will keep on. And then it says, and he that has clean hands shall be stronger and stronger. Is that you? If you are strong, will you fall? If you become stronger and stronger, and the people of the world, they frown at you, will you crumble? Will you compromise? They'll be stronger and stronger. The Lord will sustain you. Deuteronomy chapter 33 verse 25. Deuteronomy chapter 33 verse 25. Thy shoes shall be iron and brass. As thy days, so shall thy strength be. That's the amen you can say. Verse 27. The eternal God is thy refuge. Underneath you at the everlasting arms. You'll be growing stronger and stronger in there. No matter what the world throws at you, you will stand. They say like the rock of Gibraltar, and you will stand. Point number three, our consolation in Christ in the evil day. Our consolation. In Romans chapter 8, Romans chapter 8, verse 38.
You have received the message from our pastor, Pastor W.F. Kumoye, the General Superintendent of the Parallel Bible Church. It is my wish that as you listen, you accept the old word and you will let them sink into your hearts. And by the grace of the Lord, you will never regret it. It is my prayer that by next week, when our pastor shall come up again to present another message, you will be there, your family will be there, and your friends. And I believe as you are listening to the message every week, by the grace of the Lord, you will never be the same. Let us pray. Our dear Heavenly Father, we thank you, O Lord, because of today's message. We thank you, O Lord, because of the one you let us listen to last week, and the one we are going to listen to the next week, by the power and the blood of Jesus Christ. If you tarry, we shall listen together once again next week. And if not, every one of us will be there with you in the kingdom of God in Jesus' name. Thank you, Lord, because you are the Lord that answers prayer. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.